T-minus 50 seconds and counting. Coming up at T-minus 33 seconds, the GLS will hand off control to the ALS. This is the Autonomous Launch Sequencer on board the rocket. It will take over command and control of the rocket. But the ALS will check, make sure there's no holds coming from the ground up until T-minus 2
GLS,
seconds.
Go for ALS.
And we are go for ALS. The Space Launch System is now counting down to liftoff of Orion on its maiden voyage to the moon. Launch team can no longer recycle the count. Sound suppressor water now flowing 15. Under the ML. And here we go.
10.
Hydrogen ALS burnoff igniters initiated. 7, 6, 5, 4 stage engine start. 3, 2, 1, boosters in ignition. And liftoff of Artemis 1. We rise together back to the moon and beyond.
Stage and two solid rocket boosters now propelling the vehicle at 128 miles per hour. Hearing good control on the roll from teams at Mission Control Houston, all good calls so far. Now 30 seconds into the flight of Artemis 1. First milestone will be for the vehicle to pass through max Q at about 1 minute and 9 seconds into launch. This is the greatest period of atmospheric force on the rocket. SLS now traveling 607 miles per hour. You're looking at 8.8 million pounds of maximum thrust. Quiet here in the loops in Mission Control. The four core stage engines are throttling down ahead of passing through max Q. Flight traveling at 1,420 miles per hour. The four core stage engines are back at maximum thrust. The next major milestone will be for the solid rocket boosters to cut off and jettison at about 2 minutes and 11 seconds into the flight, so about 30 seconds from now.